Cabo Mary with AB Boxing News. I'm here with the Rising Prospect, Gabe Flores Jr., man. How's everything, man?
Everything's great. You know, I arrived in town yesterday and just enjoying the city.
You know, Saturday night, we got the big fight, Rigo versus Loma. Can you agree that this is like the second most important fight behind Canelo and Triple G?
It's a big fight, two gold medalists going at it. You know, you don't get that very too often. So, it's exciting. This sold out fast. So, you know, everybody's going to be quiet, all eyes on the ring when they get in the ring, and I can't wait to see the results.
There has been a lot of mixed reactions in terms of, the fans are going to be pleased with it. You know, they're both very skilled fighters. Rigo, very defensive fighter. Loma, more offensive. So, you think the fans are going to be pleased with the end result? Or
You can never predict that. You can only guess. Yeah. You know, like with the Canelo and Triple G, everybody thought that was going to be an action pack. But, you know, things change. This is boxing. You can't really predict everything. But hopefully, I'm hoping it's going to be action packed, you know. But either way, I'm going to enjoy it. It's a lot. Even though sometimes it's slow, I love to see the styles, all that. I love to see the technique.
Of course. Knowing that yourself, you're the youngest top rank, signed with top rank, right? And you just fought in Las Vegas, I believe, right?
I just fought in Reno. Yeah.
Reno, there you go. So, can you tell us what you learned from that fight and when's your next upcoming fight?
You learn anything from a fight. You know, every fight you learn something different. I think the biggest thing I learned is just picking my shots and setting them up in different places. Instead of throwing two punches in the place, just throw one hard one and get ready for the next punch. You know, we always go through new things. We always try to see mistakes and fix them. We try to fix our mistakes more than add something to our style.
With your boxing career so young, you know, who have you idolized while growing up? You know, who's your favorite boxer?
Roy Jones Jr.
Roy Jones Jr. is my favorite.
Roy Jones Jr. just made it look so easy. His hand was always down. He had style. He had flavor. He wasn't boring. And when I was young, I couldn't watch a full 12-round fight. I could watch like 6 rounds with my pops, and that was about it. I was out. But with Roy, he kept me entertained. He would check it. He was always doing something. And he just made it look like he was having fun. He didn't look like he was having a job. Looked like he was just doing something for privilege. That's the best part of it. You know, he was smiling. It was just, it's incredible, man. I never see something like that. So he's my idol. That's the man.
As 2017 comes to a near end, you know, we've seen a lot of fighters retire. Bradley, you got Klitschko, Robert Guerrero, Timothy Bradley. You know, out of those names or even other names, which one had one more in them, one more run in them? Miguel Cotto as well. Like, which fighter had it? Another run in them?
You think, if anybody, probably Andre Ward.
Andre Ward, okay.
If anybody, he could fight another year. But he's good, he don't have to. You know, nobody's obligated. He made his money, he got his world titles. You know, he's good, he's happy, he's gonna go enjoy his family, you know. So, I mean, I give him props for that. You know, some people don't know how to lead the game.
Yeah.
Like Roy Jones Jr., man, I feel like he should have lived the game and hurt me because I love him as a fighter. I grew up watching him. He was fighting before I was even born. So, but I seen all his fights, all his tapes. So to see me, for me to see him get hurt like that, it breaks my heart, you know, because he's a legend. He shouldn't go out like that. But it is what it is. You know, I can see how he couldn't give it up. But salute to Roy.
Knowing that you fight at the 130 division, who's the man to beat? You know, we got Tevin Farmer, Vasily Machenko that's fighting on Saturdays. We got other big names, Miguel Burchett. You know, who's the guy to beat at 130?
The guy to beat, that's not a question for me right now. You know, it's kind of irrelevant. I'm young.
Yeah.
I only got 5 fights. When I get 20 fights under my title, I'll be ready to talk about that. But right now, there's no reason to.
Of course. So, last question. Can you break it down between Errol Spence Jr. and Lamont Peterson at the Barclays Center January 10th?
I think Errol Spence Jr. is too much.
Yeah.
He's too fresh. He's young, he's skilled, he got a lot of power, and he'll come over anything. You know, you've seen that with the Cal Brook fight. Bother him, he's still strong-minded. And that's the main thing for me, in my opinion. That's the main thing, being strong-minded, you go and overcome anything in the ring. So, I got Errol Spence by far.
Where can we follow you?
At G_Squad_Nation on Instagram and Twitter, and Facebook, Gabriel Flores.
There you go.